Good morning, children. Today I am going to teach you mathematics in an interesting way. Today's teaching learning session is based on an activity. For doing that activity, you need some material, and those materials are scale, pencil, eraser, sketch pen, crayons, glue, and some white sheets which are easily available at your home. Now let me explain you how I utilized these materials in doing that activity. For this, I have used these white sheets. Out of these white sheets, I have made a circular shape like this. Can you see this circular shape? It is made up from this white sheets. After cutting in the circular shape, I drew something on it, and it is just like this. Can you see this? At the center of the circular shape, I have written something. Okay, children, can you see it? I have written something at the center of this circle, and of course it is number 9. If you see it properly, it is number 9. The next, what I did, I drew some lines which divides the circle into 8 parts. Okay, so after that, what I did, I am going to show you. After that, I have filled the different parts of the circle like this way. So children, is it visible clearly to you? Can you see it? Now I am going to tell you about it. So at the center of this circle, you can see that I have written 9 plus 0, 9 minus 0. So what does it mean? Yes, of course, 9 plus 0 gives the same value, 9, which I have written at the center. 9 minus 0 gives you the value 9, that equals to this 9. So these all are nothing but the different way of representing the digit 9. 9 can be represented as 81 divided by 9. It gives you the value 9. 9 can be written as 11 minus 2. 9 can also be represented as 5 plus 4. And in the same way, you can also write 3 into 3. I can show you here. 9 can be written as 3 into 3. 9 also can be represented as 10 minus 1. And here also you can see 54 divided by 6. This also give you as 9. Here also 7 plus 2 is 9. 9 into 1 is also 9. So all these different forms of 9. 9 can be written in many ways. So why I have written all this thing, I am going to explain you that all the different forms of 9 are based on the arithmetic. Now what is arithmetic? It is the operation of addition, like this, subtraction, multiplication, and division. This is called the arithmetic operations. And the digit 9 can be framed in different ways by using these operations. From this circle, you not only come to know about the arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. But also you will learn properties of addition and multiplication. So let me explain you what are these properties. Children, at the center of this circle you can see that I have written 9 plus 0 because 9 plus 0 gives you the value 9. So according to the rule, whenever we add any number with 0, it gives us the value as the same number. So 0 is called as the additive identity, and it is one of the property of addition. Next, here you can see that 9 is represented as 9 into 1 because 9 into 1 gives us the value 9. So as per the rule, whenever any number is multiplied by 1, it gives us the value 1, and 1 is called as the multiplicative identity, and it is one of the property of multiplication. So children, isn't it interesting? From this activity you came to know about different arithmetic operations and two properties, that is properties of addition and property of multiplication. So children, you can make this activity more interesting by decorating your circle as I have done. So let me show you how I have made that one. See, after decorating your circle, it will just look like this way. I have made this circle. I have colored this, all the parts of the circle like this way, and designed this circle in the form of a flower, and I can call it as arithmetic flower circle. Okay, so hope you have understood this activity, enjoyed this also, and you will try to do this activity at your home. I have designed it as a flower. You can design it as you wish to do, and you can also take any other number rather than 9 and try to represent that number in different forms as I have done. Take the help of the arithmetic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay children, that's all for today. Thank you.